Massive Metro.
The Takeover with Thembi Siyethe.
How are you, Zomani?
Still good, man.
What a great interview, and thank you so much for sharing the space with us. Thank you so much for coming to Massive Metro and just get us to, or take us through the process of wanting to be a proper actor. It's not easy at all. So I just want to wish you all the best of luck. Any last words, anything that you want to share with us, anything that you have in mind that you want the world to know out there about you, brother?
One thing. I'm young and I'm hungry.
You're hungry. Yes. Put it out there, Zomani. Yeah, you want to do more.
Cool.
What sorts of things do you want to do?
So far, I don't wanna beg them on the table. You know? But then, if you know, be surprised.
Yes, but you have open heart.
Cool.
Yes. It's about that, really opening yourself up and opening yourself to the possibilities, because you never know. We have a big brother here, my brother from another mother, Gabo Muvilagaze. I've known Gabo since I was like a kid. Basically, we started together. You know, when I was also still finding myself, with the journey never really stops, it never ends.
It doesn't.
Finding yourself, because Kabomo, I'm also reading your profile, your bio here. Like, brother, come on now. So many things.
I know.
He's a younger brother from Edebeni. He is brothers to...
For sure. I've seen him on television. Doing really great work. Very proud of the young man.
And then I thought, you know what? Let's just bring you in. Because you've been at it. And
for
I remember when we started just finding ourselves and not even really have references.
Yeah, exactly.
And yeah, now he's so fortunate, he's so blessed that he's got us.
Exactly. We didn't have that. We were like just swimming, not knowing what's going to happen. There was no one out there to look forward to look up to, you know?
So we're going to open the doors and give him the ultimate takeover.
Okay.
He's going to take over the show.
For sure.
And start asking us questions.
Wow.
Okay.
So anything that you want to know, here's Kabomo and here's your girl Tay Tay. Let's go.
Okay, Kabomo, I'm so far.
For sure.
So what I would like to know is when's on, because like you've been like up and down working hard, but then like I wasn't sure.
see, what I've learned is that you have to have you have to understand the business holistically. And obviously the easiest way to come in is through your gifts as an actor, as a musician, which is what I did. But once you're in, you need to start branching out into other spaces, like production, screenwriting, directing. So a lot of the time when people don't see you on television screens, they assume you're down and out, you're not being busy.
Yeah.
In the last 2 years, I've made 2 films.
Nice.
I've just been commissioned to do a series that I'm writing and directing. So one of the things I can advise for you to do is enjoy the acting, enjoy being in front of the camera, enjoy the love that you get, but also think
ahead.
Because it's hard to admit, and Thembi can say this to you, that it goes like this. There are times when you're like the hardest person in the world, and there are times when you're not, and the bookings are not coming in, the castings are not coming in.
Yeah.
When that happens, you need to have an establishment where you know that I can make money producing, I can make money writing, I can make money running a production company or running a management company or a PR company. So use this time to learn as much as you can. It should be fun. Don't take away the fun away from it, but also keep your eyes open. Meet people, learn from them, ask questions. I was constantly asking her when I was working with her. I was an annoyance, you know what I mean? Like, I was constantly asking, why do you do this? Why did you make this decision? Why motivated this? Why did you speak to this person? And without even being aware, I was literally being schooled on the industry, and that's the best way to do it.
Nice. That's very nice. And you, Sisi?
And me, baby. What's up? Ask.
Please, one thing, and if you guys, and of being like longing to know this, ne? If you sugar zuguti, when? So, Kalipukiti is like Lali's own 14.
Yes.
And I'm like, Yabon Jongo Manjimangfi, in this kind of lamb, it's okay. Nine your product, yes, to me, we product as a bomb.
Yes, it started all
that. Nine your product as a bomb. So, when it was like hard for you, like ain't doing anything, and when's in Jan?
Sure, I was so fortunate to meet Desiree Magraaf. For me, that's my mom.
Mommy.
Yes, that's my mom. Mommy, you know, Odezri, having to come from a group, Boom Shaka, you rely on each other a lot. Ni four. So, uyazi ukuthi kune balance. But when it gets to a point, as abantu nabo bakhule bonke, as brother and sister, you grow apart, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. And growing apart is a blessing because it gives you an opportunity to go out there and find your own way, your own journey. And that's what happened. And I found myself being alone. I found myself having to start all over again, having to find myself. And she was there to mentor me. She was there to help me out. She was there to actually say, you know what, you've got what it takes. You've got talent. You've got something that you can use and stand on your own. So Desiree was there for me. Yes, I went through a lot of things. I mean, having to have such a big name behind you and you're not making money out of it, because by three, by decided, go to, you know, we're going to pursue our own careers. We're going to pursue our own solo project. And you're on your own, known as just a dancer and maybe a rapper here and there. It's really hard. From scratch with that big name, but that name is not giving you any money. So that's why it's important to have mentors. That's why it's important to surround yourself with people that will be honest with you and tell you when you mess up. And Desiree was and still is that person that I can always give a call and say, ngilahlekile, ngicelungibonisa indlela. So I was just really, really blessed. And then she introduced me to my acting world. She introduced me to my own voice, you know, having to come up with the song and finish it up on my own and have my song alone. Even if it didn't sound wow, but it was popular. And Ngamampela, I didn't know what to do at all. I was so lost. And she said, it's sounding. We're going to go for it. Yeah. I'm going to find you the best producer, Gabby Leroux. I'm going to find you this. And she did exactly that. And you know what? Tembi was open-minded. And so I trust you. I'm going to go with you. So as I'm getting stopping, I mean, I just remained as a student. I am still a student. I am still learning. Nice. And within that, Kabomu was in the house. Kabomu was around. And Kabomu was helping me with my road. I mean, with managing my career. Making sure that I talk to the right people. Making sure that I'm safe. As being a woman in the industry, it's really risky.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, people do take advantage. Yeah, and I was blessed to have dimples. I used to call brown sugar.
At the time, and funny thing, at the time, she didn't know I was an artist. So
I didn't even know.
I was just like hands. I was just helping.
He was just there, you know. Yeah. And for me, today it makes sense good to why Ukabomu was there with me. So that was just another blessing.
I think one of the most important things you just said, actually, is being surrounded by honest people.
Yeah.
Mm. One of the most dangerous things that could happen to you, and this happened to me, is being surrounded by yes people. Yes people are people who just like, who say yes to everything, bad advice, bad company, where you spend your money carelessly, they're like, yes. Yeah. Or if you're making a bad song, they're not honest enough to say, you're way more talented than this, you can do better.
Yeah.
People who are constantly saying yes to you are dangerous. You need to have people who will love you enough to be able to tell you the truth, even if it's hard. If somebody offers you a crappy fee for a role, you need someone to say to you,
You deserve better.
Mm. Or if you can see whether this role is not worth your talent, you need somebody to say, this is not for you. Or somebody you trust to read the script for you and to offer you a role. Don't say yes to everything. Give it to somebody you trust for them to read the script for you. Make sure that the character works for who you are. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I think I totally agree with Tembi. Surround yourself
with
honest people, not just yes people who are just like, on a Wednesday, let's go to Durban. And you're patala wena. Yes, let's go. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Yeah.
You need to have people, someone to say, it sounds like fun, but can you really afford it? It's money. And
makes sense.
Didn't you say you want to save for immortal? Or you want to save for this? Into Zinjalo, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Thank you so much, Zamani Mbata, for joining us here at Massive Metro. I hope you've gained something, and thank you for sharing, and thank you for sharing, you know, with the world out there, the young people that look up to you. And rulaka letsa mahlohonolo ele raurata re rata talent ya hao re rata entertainment. I know ngiyokhakile ke manje.
No, ngiyakuzwa. Ngiyakuzwa.
Rata talent o re fanyona entertainment o re fanyona televisioning, and all the best rulaka letsa mahlohonolo.
Thank you so much for
thank
having
you
me.
So much. Thank you so much. Only on Massive Metro.